I mean, look at this. Come on. I don't want to say they knew I was coming. But I think someone tipped them off. Hold on. I think something's up with the lighting. Give me one sec. Let me check it. Here we go. And to think that they thought that this could be a determining factor in the review, they got more coming from them. We on? We live? Oh, yeah. You guys there? Oh, what's happening? So, we are in probably the most dangerous city in the United States. Most dangerous for your emotional well-being, your psychological well-being, your physical well-being, and definitely your financial well-being. Yep, that's it. We are in Las Vegas, Nevada, and we have one goal, to see what the Sin City Whole Foods is all about. We took this trip down Las Vegas Boulevard to see how extravagant, luxurious, and every other int and jurious this Whole Foods is. I'm not gonna lie, the bar was set up here. You can't see, up here. So let's go check it out. I was coming from New York, and I was looking at the weather, and it was, I saw it was like 40 degrees. I was like, what the hell? I'm trying to get away from it. Yeah. You got a favorite casino at all, or you stay away from the gambling?
I don't know the Gulf Coast.
Okay.
Appreciate it. Have a good one.
First thing I noticed when I walked into the store was it was big and it was open and there were slot machines everywhere. Okay, there weren't slot machines everywhere, but I kind of expected slot machines to be everywhere. I mean, slot machines are everywhere in Vegas. How come they weren't in Whole Foods? I mean, I don't know. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. I just don't know. But like I said, first thing I noticed, the store was wide open. It was a big store. It had an open floor plan. It wasn't condensed, some of the Whole Foods you see in the city. And you walk right in and you get smacked right in the face by the fresh fruit, the produce, all that good stuff, like a typical Whole Foods. The produce selection was on par with all the other Whole Foods, which I expected. They do a good job across the board of trying to source locally, locally being avocados from Mexico. But so starting off pretty good. The bulk section in this store was actually right next to the produce section. So you had a nice long wall of your bulk items, your beans, your nuts, your seeds, all that good stuff. The selection wasn't that good. In my opinion, I've seen the store on Long Island has had the best selection in the bulk area thus far in terms of organic and just a wide variety of different options. I'm not a big stickler. I know you guys know I like the bulk area. I may let this one pass. Now, the bulk area was in the front of the store. You had the produce to the right, and then right in the very front was the juice bar, and that had all your standard smoothies, juice, coffee, all in one. Pretty typical, nothing special there, but it had it as an option. Always key. Now, as I made my way around the back, I noticed something, and it was a little different than most Whole Foods. A full open section dedicated to booze. They had big wine selection. You have your beer, obviously, and then a whole aisle of liquor. I didn't check the price. I skimmed kind of right through it. But I can tell you this. The prices for bottles there are probably a million times cheaper than the prices of bottles in the hotel and anywhere on the strip. So if you want to get some liquor in, go for it. There's a little liquor surprise a little later in the video here with this Whole Foods, which is a little interesting. I've seen it in a couple of places, but we'll catch it at the end. Going around the back, there was the meat and fish section. As you guys know, I don't partake in the meats and fish. So with my best judgment, they seem fully stocked and a great selection there. What I'm beginning to notice at the whole body areas, if they're not, I've seen some separate stores attached. We'll visit that one, that's a cool one. But the whole body areas are typically in the middle of the store and they have that breakout of aisles. They have two main aisles and then little aisles in between where you could get all that self-care products. It's Valentine's week, so big teddy bears with hearts on them. I was thinking about, you know, seeing if the maid in the hotel would be my Valentine. I don't know. I'm sure I could find one in Vegas. As we move around that back corner, again, big open hot food area where you have your nice little olive bar. Across that side wall is your food stations. You can make sandwiches, you could get pizza, you can get some select hot food items. So vast selection there. In the front is where the actual hot food stations are, where you can make your own plate, make your own bin, pay $10.99 a pound. I mean, who could ask for anything more, right? And then, I told you there was a booze surprise. In the front left or right, depending on what way you're looking at. In the front, in the corner, by that hot food station, we had a Whole Foods bar. Now, I've seen this in a couple of stores, especially where they're allowed to sell liquor in the stores. But this is a nice compliment. And, you know, being in Vegas, I expected something a little extra. And the bar helped out a good amount. So a nice, fully stacked bar. You could order some food, sit down, watch the game, have a couple of drinks. This Whole Foods, I mean, it's hitting it all. It's hitting the health with the fresh produce and selections. The family, it's a family experience. Bring the family, come on, this is fun. I bet families travel to Vegas just to see the Whole Foods. Screw the Grand Canyon, we're going to Whole Foods, right? And then coming across the front, standard checkout lanes, my cashier, sweetheart. She was a sweetheart. I hope the sound works properly in my walkthrough.
How are you today?
Sweetheart. Very nice. Very nice. She was great, okay? So, in the end, Whole Foods, Sin City, Las Vegas, Nevada, right down Las Vegas Boulevard. We're coming in at a solid 3.9. That's the review. Let me give you a little bonus tip. Typically, everyone complains, Whole Foods, it's so expensive. You know, whole paycheck, ha 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 ha. Well, let me tell you something. If you're in Vegas and you're staying on the Strip or probably anywhere in Vegas, Whole Foods is probably your cheapest option. I got a Fiji water. Big Fiji water. Fiji water, 1.5 liters, big guy, $2. Those same Fiji waters that are right back there, that are half the size, sitting in a little electronic device that if you even touch it, the room automatically charges. Like, I'm scared to touch that stuff over there. $10, pot of one, $10. For a Fiji water half the size of this $2 Fiji water. Welcome to Las Vegas. So that is it. If you found this valuable, entertaining, stupid, whatever, hit that like button, subscribe. More Whole Foods videos to come. We're on a quest to find the best Whole Foods in America. And I don't know if they're international, but I'll have to look that up. That being said, thanks for stopping by. Truly appreciate it. Good eating.
Too soft. Way too soft. Gonna hurt.